Hi everybody, welcome back to Star Stable. So I just logged on and I was going to continue that quest with Captain Bruce and Alex, but we got a text from James, so click on it to read. If you close the text message, it will show again when you next log in. Okay, so let's see what it says. So he says, "Disaster, get here quick. Why are you still reading? Emergency, hurry." Okay. See, I'm right beside you, James, you're so lazy. "Why did it take you so long to get here? It's all falling apart here, or at least it's the beginning of the end for my business, and you just waltz in here slower than a sloth. No tips for you, Dragoslava." Not that you ever paid me anyway. "Nightmare, Dragoslava. You've got to help me. What's happened, you ask? The lighthouse on the South Hoof Peninsula has gone out. It's a complete disaster. No tourist ships dare to come close to Fort Pitt if the lighthouse isn't there to guide them. And if there are no tourists, then I don't make money. This is so dreadful for me. If I shouldn't just call a lighthouse keeper and ask what's going on? Do you think I'm stupid? Of course I've done that already. I've called loads of times, but there's no answer. Something must have happened. You'll help me, though, right, Dragoslava? You will. Sweet. I've had an idea. A while back, I bought a pair of really nice, cozy little boats that I thought were about hiring out to the tourists. For some reason, nobody ever hired them out, which I think is a bit weird, because going out in a boat is super fun, so I've been told. But anyway, you can borrow one so you can sail over to South Hoof, but what do you think, Dragoslava? Why I don't just go myself? I'm allergic to water." Exactly, yeah, that's it. So, unfortunately, I can't go. The boat is down there between the pier and the beach. Good luck. Okay, let's go. So I think I know where that is. Let's go see. Oh wait, there's a new pier. Ooh, now I'm super curious. Right. Right. I think there's a boat here. Yep, must be here. Okay. Let's inspect it. It's full of water. Okay. Alright, well, it's full of water, so let's go back and tell him so. Not much use if it's full of water. That's probably why nobody's hired it, because it's full of holes. "Have you already been to South Hoof?" "You haven't. The boat was broken, you say? That's ridiculous. I paid 10 Yorvik shillings for each of those boats. Maybe there's a hole or two in the bottom. But they're just there to keep you cool anyway while you're out in the water, like air conditioning in the car. Why do you look so suspicious, Dragoslava?" "Because it's you, James. Because it's you." Okay. "The boat might not be in top condition, but I have another. I rented it out to the guard at the disco so we could practice landing maneuvers at the beach or something. You can go and ask him if you can borrow that one instead. Attention, Dragoslava. How can I be of assistance to you on this day?" "Well, I hope you can be." "What on earth? You want to borrow a boat from me?" "Aha, you mean the landing craft. I borrowed it in order to rehearse crucial beach storming maneuvers, Operation Iron Cockroach, as I call it." "Grr, there's not much boat to borrow. Unfortunately, my beach landing to rehearsals came a little too realistic, even for me. No time to waste, though. I realise you're on an important mission, Dragoslava, so I hereby submit my report of Operation Iron Cockroach. The time was 04:07 yesterday morning, as I was out at sea off Fort Pinta, carefully and steadily approaching the reach. Just next to the diving board, I saw a guard post. The element of surprise was lost and my position uncovered, so I went full speed ahead and to get into the shore before the enemy had a chance to react. Suddenly I heard a huge explosion, a mine, I thought, so I threw myself straight into the water and then realised the fuel tank on the landing craft had exploded. So I swam to the land and retreated to the fort. The enemy guard revealed himself in better light to actually be a particularly suspicious looking bush. So no actual danger was present, and I gave myself an order to stop the exercise. How it went with the boat? Oh, I've got no idea. I haven't had a chance to run recon over the terrain yet, since I got light bulbs to change and the disco ball to polish first. During my retreat, I saw Ellen running towards me. She's a lifeguard down on the beach below Fort Pinta. Suppose you could ask her if she saw what happened to the boat. Okay, I think I saw her whenever we were down there earlier, so we'll go ask her. Lovely day today. Wouldn't you say, hi, my name's Ellen, and I'm the lifeguard here at the beach. What's your name? The guard's accident, I knew it was him sneaking away through the bushes. He looked pretty baffled. If I saw what happened to his boat, yeah, I ran here when I heard the explosion, so I didn't see the actual accident. But whatever ends up in the water here usually drifts ashore along the foreland, which crops out over the past bathing area. If it is his boat didn't sink, it's pretty sure to have ended up there. If you find the boat, you could come and let us know, since I need to be sure it won't be dangerous for people who come swimming here. Oh, there's the boat. whatever ends up in the... Oh, gosh. That doesn't look good at all. Alright, well, we'll go tell her that. Did you find the boat? Bits of it, you say. Why are you so interested in a wonky old boat like that anyway? Oh, you need a boat to get to South Hoof. And James' other boats are much better. We're pretty much the same shape. Maybe there's a chance you can repair the boat with the parts you find here. Worth a try, right? It's pretty quiet here right now, so I can help you if you like. If the other boat is also broken, you probably need to fix that as well. Maybe there's some stuff in the wreck you can use for that. I'll go and take a look at the boat while you look over here for the parts on the beach that you can use. What do you say? Nice! Have a look along the little peninsula where you found the wreck. Everything that's sunk has probably washed ashore there. See if you know, while by the pier where the boat is. Okay, so we need to go and get these bits down here then. That looks like they're going to be reasonably easy to get. Right, we need 5 pieces. There's another one. Oh, missed it. Ginger cake, go back. Probably would have been quicker to just build the life raft, to be honest. I'm going this way somewhere. Must be someone here. Yeah, there we go. Another one down here. One man's rack is another man's boat. Oh dear. Right, let's go see if we can actually fix this boat. Hi again. Looks like you found loads of useful stuff. We'll definitely be able to make use of this. Well, Drahoslava, I don't see there being any problems with sealing the hull of your boat with the parts we have here. We just need to get hold of some kind of glue or sealant to hold it all together. The engine, on the other hand, is a different story. You'll need to find the wreck's engine if you're going to have any chance of fixing it. You didn't see an engine on the shore, you say. I guess it sank when the fuel tank exploded on the guard's boat. It's probably on the seabed out in the diving board at the bathing spot. Have a look there and see if you can salvage it. There, here's the anchor from the boat. Perhaps you could use it as a kind of fishing hook to fish out the engine. Use the rope to fish out the engine. Come on back once you've found it, and I'll see if I can find a way to use these parts you've found in the meantime. Okay, well, if you could do that, that would be real helpful. Right, danger kick, I'll be back in a minute. Right. Let's see now. How do we do this? I think we need to open our inventory. Let's do it. Oh. Well, might work. Never know. Not a bite. Well, we aren't looking for fish. Let's try this. Come on. Must be here somewhere. Nope. How about this next bit? Might find something eventually, I guess. Oh! Yay, we found it. Alright, now that we've got the engine, that's a good start. Nice work! Now we'll have enough spare parts and then some. Good. A thin sealant. I reckon I should be able to get the engine going for you, Drahoslava. I was a mechanic at the York City scrapyard before I became a lifeguard here. I hardly ever saw the sunshine at that scrapyard, so change of career was pretty much the best decision I ever made. Anyway, I saw a barrel of sealant further down the pier. That should do the trick from sealing up to the hull. It should have been delivered to my friend, Donald the Builder in Yarlan, but it's been sitting there for weeks now, so I guess the ferry captain must have forgot about it. Would you ride over and get it? I'll text Donald now and ask him if it's okay we use it. He'll say yes, so ride over and grab it now. You seem quite sure of yourself. What's the other bit that we need? Well, I'm sure we'll get some speed out of this engine eventually. I've got some tools you can borrow, but maybe you could do me a favour in return. Yesterday night, I took a quick little dip down in the pier on the other side of the Fort Pinta. It was pretty late around that time. The guard was out on his little adventure in the boat. When I heard the explosion, I ran out there. I didn't grab no shoes or nothing and got to the beach as quick as I could. I ended up leaving more than just my shoes. All my clothes are still over there. Do you think you can grab them for me? Thanks, Drahoslava. But what were you doing, young lady? Swimming around at that time of night? Right. Got it. Now we just need to go find her stuff. Ah, there we go. Gosh, everything's everywhere. Or maybe we just have to look around here, maybe that's all. Okay, we found one thing. Now, what about the rest? Hopefully we'll find them quickly.
Yep.
Oh, and my last one, hopefully.
Nope.
Maybe this one?
Nope.
We were really lucky at first. Now we're not so lucky.
Yay!
Okay, we got them. Exactly, that's the barrel I was talking about. Oh, speak of the devil, a text from Donald. He writes that we should just take as much sealant as we need, and if there's something else, there's never a shortage of it, sealant. Sounds good, Drahoslava. Donald usually knows what he's talking about. Oh, thanks, Drahoslava. They're my favourite clothes, so I was a bit worried that they might have gone missing. Now I just need to use that sealant to seal the hull of the boat with the parts from the wreck you found earlier. You shouldn't have any problems making it watertight. I'll wait here just to ask if you need anything. Okay, what's the last bit? Boat engine repairs. Here are my tools, Drahoslava. I haven't really used them in the time since I left the scrapyard in New York City, but they're still in good condition, as I'm sure you'll notice. You know how to repair an engine, right? Of course. I even asked. Good luck, and let me know if you need anything. Right. Okay, we know need all of our skills for this. Okay, so we've got sealant, and we've got the engine. So let's use the sealant first. See if we can fix this. It's looking pretty bad still. Oh, okay, we got the water out of it. That's good. Now we just need to do, not fall in the water. I can actually get the toolkit out. That would be great. There we go. Now we should get somewhere. Okay, that's fixed now. Great, that hull isn't going to let a drop of water into it now. You're not a bad mechanic. You could get a job at the scrapyard if you wanted. The engine looks like it was delivered straight from the factory. Well, thank you. There we go, Drahoslava. Now your boat is as good as new. All you need now is to fill the tank with fuel so you can sail away. Fuel? You didn't get any fuel from James. Well, without fuel you won't be getting very far. Probably best you write to him and ask him for some. I need to get back to Lifeguarding Beach now. But it was really nice to meet you. Nice to be able to use my old skills again as well. That doesn't happen much anymore. Good luck over at South Beach. See you around. Right, well, we're going to go ask James for fuel, and I think James is going to be typical James and be like, get your own fuel. But we'll see about how the doubt he's actually going to give us any fuel. Highly, highly doubt it. Hey, Drahoslava, have you already been over to South Hoof? You need fuel for the boat, you say? Fuel's so expensive. You sure it's necessary? Can't you row? James, I'm not rowing. Not a chance. Okay, I get it. If the lighthouse doesn't light back up again, it'll be a disaster for my business. I don't have so much in the way of cash flow right now, Drago. So maybe you've got a good idea of where we could get hold of some cheap fuel. Steve, he's got a huge fuel tank, you say. Oh, do you think you could get some from him? Great idea, Drahoslava. That way it'll be free. Quick, right over to Steve and get some fuel. No time to waste. Yeah, you're just making me steal Steve's fuel, to be honest. You're not borrowing it. You're not going to give it back to him. Hello to you, Drahoslava. Fuel? Well, of course. I'm sure we can arrange something. You need some fuel, you say. Well, I'm sure I can spare some for you. After all, you wouldn't do for a good old friend, huh? I actually need to fuel up some of my machines, too. So do you think... do you know what? He's going to ask me to do those as well. Take these two empty fuel cans, Drahoslava. Fill them both up, and you can keep one of them. Does that sound okay? Good. See you soon. Okay, there's one. And two. Two cans of fuel. Oh, one for me, one for you. It was a delight to see you, young Drahoslava. Here's your can of fuel, filled to the brim with top-notch propellant. Good luck and say hello to James for me. I don't know why you'd want to say hello to James, but fair enough. Hey, Drahoslava, did you get some fuel from Steve? A whole can for free? That Steve's got no idea how to do business, but you don't hear me complaining. Yeah, no, you'd never complain about anything for free. What are you waiting for, Drahoslava? Ride down to the boat, fill her up with the fuel, and set sail for South Hoof. Hurry, because without tourists, Fort Pitt is going to go under, or well, at least my business will. See ya. Right, we're going. We can only go so fast. Right, let's see, did that work? The fuel tank of the boat's engine is now filled to the brim with fuel. It's finally time to cast off and set sail for South Hoof. Okay, I think we need to click on this to go anywhere. Where would you like to go? South Hoof. You steer the boat towards South Hoof Ferry Landing. Cool. This would be cool to see a new area. You sail over to South Hoof. A path leads upwards. Maybe there'll be someone further along it. Okay, let's go have a look. Wow, this is cool. There's Fort Pinto over there. Let's go exploring. It's pretty. It is quite pretty, I have to say. Oh, wow. I like this place. South Hoof Farm. Let's see what's in here. Oh, it is a very pretty place. Chickens, my mortal enemies. There's not a single person around. You listen, but all you can hear is the wind whistling through the grass. There must be someone around here. You can ask about what might have happened to the lighthouse. You decide to look around the garden. I really like this new area. It's really pretty. I just kind of want to explore it a minute. Where was the garden is the question. Is it this way? Oh, there. There's something. Oh, there's a person. Oh, wow. You scared the life out of me. Hello there. By the way, who are you? Drahoslava, nice to meet you. My name's Holly. Just got back from my surf session on the other side of South Hoof. This time of year, I don't think you'll be able to find better waves anywhere in the world. Hey, by the way, have you seen Eric, my husband? You haven't? Madison, where's my daughter? Madison, she's my daughter. You haven't seen either. Okay, you haven't seen another living soul at all. Very strange. There must be around here somewhere. Let's take a look around the garden together. I'm sure we'll find someone. Okay. There's that. Oh, I see something. Sparkles. Nope, nobody there. Okay. Alright, this is the garden. There's a lot of carrots. Danger cake, I know what you're thinking. Carrot cake and lots of carrot cake, but now is not the time. There's loads of stuff around here. Oh! That doesn't look hopeful either. What are about around here? Oh, no. Nobody here. Oh, wait a minute. I think I saw something in there. I don't know, it was just sparkles. No, it was just sparkles. Let's see. Something behind her as well. Okay. Nope. Don't know where they are. They've all been kidnapped. Well, we couldn't find anybody. Everyone's disappeared. This is pretty weird. What are you doing here, by the way, Drahoslava? The lighthouse isn't working. What? Something must have happened while I was away. I've never seen the lighthouse go dark, and my whole family have just vanished. Something must have happened. Quick, we're going to have to get to the lighthouse fast. Maybe they're there. Follow me, Drahoslava. Okay. Oh, we've a right way jog to go by the looks of it. Right. Let's go, Danger Kick. Right, she went this way. Better catch her up. Well, I suppose it doesn't matter if we overtake her. I think we know where we're going, so. Got a rough idea. Go up this way. Didn't see anybody so far. South Hoof Lighthouse. Well, there's some sparkles. The The door's locked and nobody's answering. When I knock, where can they be? We've got to find the key to the lighthouse door, Drahoslava. Sarah, the lighthouse keeper, has a spare key hidden around here somewhere. I just can't be sure where it is. Where on earth is it? You think we should split up so we can look faster? Great idea. Quick. We need to find it. Right, where would we hide a lighthouse key? Hopefully at the front steps. That would be really handy. Probably not be, though. Nope. Didn't think so. What about around here? Ooh, this is quite high up. This is very high up. Alright, let's go to the edge without falling off. Oh, there's even more stuff over there. Don't know if we can get over there, though, if the looks of it. Alright, let's see what else is around here. Oh, we can go down to the beach, by the looks of it. Dead man sands. Oh, there's some sparkles behind us. Nope, nothing there. What about over here? Oh, yeah, we found it. Awesome. We got the key. You found the key. Yep, we did. Quick, Drahoslava, unlock the door. If they're not in there, then perhaps we'll see something from the top of the lighthouse. Suppose that's a good idea. All right. Ginger Kick, you wait there, because I'm not sure if you can go in the lighthouse or not. Right. Where's the key? There's the key. You look for Holly's family from the top of the lighthouse. Oh? Yeah, there's people down there. Isn't that the other island we were looking at a minute? That must be them. Some of those look a bit suspicious looking to me. Right, let's see. They're alive, thank goodness. Did you see them, Drahoslava? Yeah, me too. That's the whole family, Sarah, Jonas, Eric, and Madison. But how did they all manage to get stranded at Cape Sorrow? I haven't the foggiest. I don't know how they managed to get themselves stuck at Cape Sorrow, Drahoslava, but we need to rescue them. They must have been there at least a day, and I couldn't see any food, camping gear, or anything. They must be freezing and hungry. And poor little Madison, I hope she's okay. You've got a horse, Drahoslava. Can I sit behind you while you ride? Great. Ride down to the beach below the lighthouse, Drahoslava. It's opposite Cape Sorrow. You'll need to take the path going past the ferry landing since there's no other way to get down the cliffs here. Come on, Drahoslava. Let's see if my family. Right, okay. Let's go. If I can actually get back on. Right, I think we need to go all the way back over and then we need to go down, I think, as far as she said. So we'll do that now. I think I've seen a bit off to the side when we came up from the ferry, so I think that's the bit she's talking about. Because all of this looks like it's pretty well covered and there's no other way down. Yeah, I think we're gonna need to go further down. Ferry dock was this way, I think. Sorry for running over your carrots. I apologize, but it is really pretty. I really like the flowers and everything. Yep, looks like we can go this way. So the question is then, how do we get over once we get down here, I suppose? I'm not too sure yet how we're going to do that. But we'll see. It is pretty spectacular cliffs, I have to say. It'll be really interesting to explore this place further. I like the music too. Right. Where are we? We're not far from them now, because that was what we were looking down at earlier. Let's see. Right. Drop me off here then. Hello, can you hear me? The wind is so strong, Drahoslava, they can't hear me while I yell. I think they've seen us, though. They seem to be alright, don't they? Madison looks like she's in good shape. Wait, can you see Jonas? He looks rather weak. I hope he's not injured. How are we going to get to Cape Sorrow, Drahoslava? I can't see Jonas' fishing boat or our little motorboat anywhere. I'll try to get there on my surfboard, but that just gets swept out to sea or smashed up against the cliffs. Could be worth a try anyway, right? What do you think, Drahoslava? I suppose we don't have any other choice. We've got a boat, you say. Of course you have. How else would you have got here? Hurry up and bring it here. I'll wait here and try to come up with a plan in the meantime. How are we going to bring the boat down here? Unless we get in the boat and we bring it down here, I guess. Right, let's see if we can get down there. You're back at the boat, still in great condition. Good. You cast off and set sail towards Holly. Right, Dendrocake, let's go. We've got a rescue mission to do. You steer the boat towards Dead Man Sands. Okay. Nice boat, Drahoslava, but are you sure it'll be seaworthy? It looks a pretty lousy ship. Hey, I spent ages fixing that boat. Drahoslava, I think it's best if you take the boat to Cape Sorrow yourself. The more space you have in the boat, the fewer trips you'll need to make to pick one up. Just take it easy, okay? The waters around Cape Sorrow are full of really strong currents and dangerous ground. Plenty of ships and boats have met their end at the Cape, and I really don't want to join them. Good luck. Oh, thanks. Me and Dendrocake will just brave the danger. How do I do this? Do I just... Cape Sorrow. Okay. You steer the boat towards Cape Sorrow. Okay, well, they all look reasonably alright. Hello there, I'm Sigrid, South Hoof's lighthouse keeper. Might I ask who you are? Drahoslava, delightful. You're here to save us, you say. I saw you on the way here and you're a decent navigator, but is your boat really seaworthy? Why does everybody keep doubting my boat? Now, how are we feeling, you ask? Considering the circumstances, everyone's doing rather well, except for my husband Jonas. He says he's fine, but I know he's just trying to not worry me. He was in the water long after the boat went down, and he gave all the dry clothes he managed to save to Madison so she doesn't freeze. His temperature was right down, and even though he's stronger than a walrus, he might. What happened, you ask? Well, Jonas had taken Madison out on a fishing trip, and when they were on the way home, Jonas steered a little too close to Cape Sorrow. He knows how dangerous the water is here, but he wanted to show Madison one of his favourite cliffs out this way. It was pretty stupid of him. But he meant well, as he always does. The fishing boat ran aground and sank almost immediately, but Jonas managed to swim ashore with Madison. I saw what happened from up in the lighthouse, so I ran down to the farm and got Eric. Together we took out our boat and got to Cape Sorrow as quickly as we could, but sadly Eric always managed to run aground. Jonas had to throw himself into the water again to save us. He got up onto the shore, but I think it was too much, even for my lovely brave husband. I don't think there's any danger to my Jonas, but maybe you should take a look at him. Right, well, we'll go check on him. He's got a Superman cape. You look alright to me, Jonas. Oh, hello. Maybe not. I'm almost back on my feet again. No worries, bro. Tell Sigrid that she doesn't have to worry. Well, tell her it's just not to worry about. I don't know. How does Jonas seem to you, Drahoslava? How's he feeling? He says everything's fine. He said so to me as well. Do you believe him? No, I don't either. He doesn't want to worry me, so he's just saying he feels okay. You think he's quite seriously sick? Oh, no. Drahoslava, take Jonas back to Holly right away. The rest of us can cope here a little while longer. Don't worry. Ask Holly to take Jonas up to the farm. She needs to make sure he's warm and gets plenty of rest. Hurry now. Right, Jonas, you may come with me. Right, where's my boat? Right, yes. Hey, Drahoslava, everyone's fine, you say. That's a relief to hear, but how's Jonas? Jonas, are you alright? Oh, you appeared there. Sigrid asked me to take him straight back to the farm, you say. Absolutely, we'll get up there as fast as we can. Will you be alright to get the others on your own, Drahoslava? Great. Jonas, can you hear me? Put your weight on me and we'll get back to the farm so you can rest. See you at the farm soon enough, Drahoslava. Good luck. Alright, hopefully don't have to go back and forth and back and forth for everybody. Right, Cape Sorrow. How did it go with Jonas? Holly took him straight up to the farm, he said. Good, everything would turn out fine then. As long as Jonas gets up warm and has a little rest, he should be fine in no time. Eric Madison, listen now. This is Drahoslava, she's here to rescue us. Go over and sit in the boat so she can take us back to South Hoof. Everything will be fine. The boat is safe and we don't need to worry, okay? Hurry along now. There you go then, Drahoslava. We're ready to head back to South Hoof. Sail carefully, you promise? Of course I'm going to sail carefully. I'm not silly like James. Eric, Madison, hurry home now. Go at once. You need to get warm and have some food. Hurry along now. Drahoslava, I'll give you my thanks. If it wasn't for you, I'm not sure we would have made it, if I'm honest. Well, away they go. I'm so worried about my husband, Drahoslava. Imagine if he's seriously ill. I need to hurry back to the farm. I can I can sit behind you on your horse, you say. I haven't ridden so much, Drahoslava. Are you sure it'll be okay? Okay, thank you. To the farm. Right, off we go. Right, I'll set you down over here then. Home at last. It's never been nicer to get back home as it is now. Thanks for the ride, Drahoslava. Now I need to check on my Jonas. Jonas seems to be feeling better already, Drahoslava. Some food and heat seem to have done the trick. But now we'll just have to keep an eye on him in future. No more adventures at sea. Drahoslava, my Jonas tells me he would love to thank you in person. Go talk to him, but not for too long. He needs his rest. Right, Jonas, you should be in bed. Hello there, Drahoslava. That was your name, wasn't it? It's a lovely name, if you don't mind me saying so. Oh. You'll have to excuse me. I'm incredibly tired. Quite enough adventure for one day, wouldn't you say? Maybe we can have a talk a little tomorrow. Does that sound good, Drahoslava? See you in the morning, then. Right. Well, we can come back tomorrow, but let's go explore for a little bit. And see what else there is. So we've been up to the lighthouse. And there's quite a large area. Wow, this place is massive. Right. There is a lot of open grassland around here. I really like the music. I know I've said that already, but I really do like it. I hope we'll get competitions and things around here. It would be really cool. I'm gonna put some stuff on so that I can go a little bit faster. Now, where's my saddle? There it is. I like all the little rocks and things around here as well. This place is really, really big. Huge, in fact. I don't know if it's gonna like stay quite like this or if they're gonna add more things, but it'd be nice to see anyway. There's plenty of beach to have a look around, that's for sure. Let's see now, there's like Stonehenge over there. I wanna go over there in a minute. Now, is this like a sheer cliff or can you go down? No, it seems to be pretty sheer cliffs. But you can get down on them, it looks like. Right, let's have a look at the Stonehenge place. Looks like we can get down here too. Right, come on up and over this way. This place looks really interesting. It is such a huge, huge area. I actually can't get over the size of this area. It's massive. I could literally probably spend 2 weeks going around here just looking. Oh wow, that's really cool. It's really eerie. Ooh, spooky. It's got all spooky. It's like really mystical and I like that. That is quite cool. Whoops, I didn't even see that. Whoopsie. Right. I wonder what else is over here. Oh! I see something else. Looks like a town. Can we get over there? I think we can. Awesome. Ooh! Whoops. You're in a closed area. We moved home. No! I didn't know. That's not fair. How am I supposed to know? Oh no, it took me back to Fort Pinta! No! Well, that's just silly. How was I supposed to know? It doesn't actually, there's no warning. I just ran off a cliff. Alright, let's go get back in the boat. Alright, seeing as we can't go too far that way, it seems, but we'll just not go down this time. I don't want to kick back all the way to Fort Pinta, because that's just a pain. It should have just kicked me out of the area that I was in. I didn't even know I couldn't go there. I don't see anything on the map that tells me I can't. No, it doesn't. It doesn't tell me. So how am I supposed to know?
Last minute. Maybe it's that wee bit. Hold on.
Maybe that's what we tried, or maybe it was there we fell in. Sunset Islands. Okay, that must have been it. We either fell down here, somewhere here.
Beaches are pretty around here.
I think I figured out why we got kicked out. Because I think we fell into a different area, which I think is like the Sunset Islands or something that we can't go to yet. So I think that's why we got kicked out. I'm not entirely sure, but I was looking at the map and it seems to be that was why. So that explains it a bit. Let's see, we'll try and look across, but we'll not try and fall off any cliffs this time. I wasn't trying to fall off the cliff, I just happened to fall off the cliff. Oh, it's really pretty from over here. You can see Fort Pinto really well as well. Right, don't fall off, don't fall off, don't fall off. I don't want to get kicked all the way back. Oh, it's really, really grassy here. Oh, okay, so this must be a new area that will be unlocked in future. I just wish it was more obvious that you're, like, you couldn't go down there, because I just fell. I didn't mean to fall. But it's quite big, actually, the looks of it. Looks to be quite large. It looks like there's some kind of temple over there. No, don't fall in there again. I don't want to get kicked. So that must be what that's about. So I'll not try to go down again, because I do not want to get thrown all the way back again. It is really pretty, the looks of it. Right, what else is there over this way? I just love the way the rocks and everything, and it's all barren, and the trees and everything. It's just, it's a really nice feel to it. I think. Okay. I'll have a look. Yeah, this is Sunset Island, so we must have fell into that earlier. So that's what that is. Oh god, don't fall in again, don't. Ninja Kick, you're taking too many risks. Stop it. Get out of there. Thank you. Well, guys, I'm gonna leave it there. I hope you had a lovely day. Bye!